Hey guys, and there we are again. In the last video, we were fighting 1v3, and I got heavily bullied by my Austrian and Indian friends. We fought like let's bully the let's bully the German today. So now we're playing even 1v4, so it's even harder. But this time, I don't have 120% handicap. I have 200% handicap. Happy also had the idea to assign me a Sif, but he wanted to give me Armenians, and I was like, no, I cannot play Armenians like that in this matchup. Like, I would be open for some like Sif recommendations. If you guys recommend me like 3 Sifs, I can pick one of those. But what's the shit? Why does everyone have a handicap now? No, but honestly, how did this happen? I didn't push anything. Roy, admit it, you used your hacker skills and you hacked my age, right?
Okay, so let's see which Sifs you can decide between.
Mohammed, I think if you haven't decided which Sifs you're taking, Semper needs to be in a different.
No.
Guys, I already decided on a Sif. Now, let me at least have my Sif that I want to pick here. So I pick my Sif now. And okay. Can we please make an arrangement that we don't do any double cutting, like opening two sides or stuff like that? Because then it's getting really sick.
Just war properly, that's the point.
Oh boy.
You got your Sif, Sempa?
Yeah, okay, we won't do double cuttings, we will do triple cuttings.
So.
Okay. Okay, then you can leave the chat and we're gonna talk through which we're gonna pick.
Good. That having been said, I will leave the voice chat. I wish good luck, have fun to you guys.
Yeah,
and good luck to you as well. I hope that this game will help me to restore my how's it called?
Honor?
My honor, exactly. Honor? My honor as an H player. I hope this game will restore it all.
Yep. Okay.
I'm leaving and I'll see you after the game, guys, okay?
Yeah, okay. See you later.
See you.
So, there we go. Do I pick Georgians is the question. I mean, Georgians are not too shabby because we have their Monaspa, but I only have Monaspa as long as I have gold. And I could sell some food, of course, but I could also make some siege options, which are really nice, like siege ram, halberdier. I think they're pretty versatile. I was also thinking about Magyars. Maybe I pick Magyars, but Georgians are pretty cool actually so far. Do I pick Georgians or do I pick Magyars? Yeah, I think I will just pick Georgians. I just pick Georgians and let's see how this is going. And this time, if you watched the other video, in the other video, Roy was like, oh, please don't attack us, you're cutting the trees, we are not ready for you. And I was still giving him time. And I mean, that was more than fair for me, because I was fighting 1v3, and then even giving them time to fully boom, that's a bit too much, and it turned out to be a little bit too much. This time I will show no mercy. I will come as soon as I can, and I will spam in Monaspa, and I will completely destroy them, like as soon as possible. So I will show no mercy in this game. Last game I was too friendly and too nice. This time it's full on war mode.
My granny can scrap better than that.
No. Yes. No.
I'll beat you back to Age of Empires.
Sure, blame it on your ISP.
Attack
Long
player
time,
eight.
No siege.
Attack player four. Attack player two.
I need a monk.
So.
Enemy sighted.
For some reason, Ice is not getting ready. Let me quickly switch to Discord again.
Also.
Greetings to you. Ice does. Okay, sorry. I wanted to say he doesn't. Really
Looks like okay. Easier to interrupt than a final okay. Or secret
yeah, yeah, possible. See you in the game, guys. So, let's go. So, is it Mongols again? Mongols, Teutons? I could imagine Hindustani. Maybe Ice could play like Kevsev, like Hans. Ice is playing Turks, interesting. And Happy is playing Khmer. I hope he won't cut the trees, because that would be super annoying. Oh, actually, it's not too bad, because then I don't have to make onagers if they are cutting already. Maybe it's even good for me if they're cutting the trees. So.
Zaars. Rasach Shemgrebeli. Zaars. Shemgrebeli. Ostreemak Shemgrebeli.
Yeah, to be honest, I think I will get beaten again, but I don't care, I take it as a good sport. I mean, it would get pretty boring also for the audience if I was always winning with stuff. Then I can spam Hasa, I can spam Halberdier. My skirms are halfway decent, they only lack pumpering and the last armor upgrade. So even skirms are an option. I can make siege ramps, but most of all I can make Monaspa, which will be really sick. I think I will just make an army of Monaspa, cut the trees, and see how much damage I can deal with that, and the rest I try to solve with... the rest I will try to solve with Hasa and Halberdier spam. So is there any cow or something like that? No. Okay, something's going on.
Rogan?
No. Yes. Yes.
Okay. Oh, I can actually go over here. And eat some of those tasty deers over here. I think I can also go up to Fuglage already. So I can get to Castle Age faster. The thing is, when I get to Feudal Age fast, I can get my eco upgrades also fast. It's of course a bit weird to go up with 18 pop, but when you have 200 handicap, that actually makes more sense than most people would think. I want to get to Castle Age as fast as possible so I can make extra TCs. Let's see how this will work out. So let's get the piggy in. Actually, I can do the war with my scout because my cavalry is healing. Didn't think about this before. That's actually making a lot of sense here. Yeah? So, let's get this. Oh, my gold and so on is very close to the front line. I don't like this. Let's get to Castle Edge. So, you can make some houses. I need some guys on wood so I can make my casis. If you want to know about the music, I put in the original soundtrack of the game, so yeah. No. Score is still relatively close to each other, which is weird because of our handicap that I have.
Get your arse. Get your arse. Arma schöne Belly. Arma schöne Belly. Arma schöne Belly.
So, we're all moving up. But I should be faster. Monastery is very important buildings with Armenians as well as with Georgians. The score is still very close, considering that I have so much handicap. No, I've said this already. I just wanted to save it again.
Martha, Okay, the house wall is going up, that's good. So, the village is in.
Ketil Ars, чем кредит.
Арма шёны бели.
Краса, цаугани плаха силы хрэстрэй.
And this time I feel more confident. Jetzt muss ich das well. It was that we're creating a labyrinth over here. It's really neat. Yeah, but I shall find my way in. We shall find my way into this. Is my market? Is my hello? Am I blind? Ah, okay.
Get you,
Wie geht ihr Ars? Tauche in Arma schöne Belli. Arma schöne Belli. Arma schöne Belli.
Geht sie hier?
Finden wir kein Sendovers und Dudes, aber ich jetzt vor zum Raiding. Oh Gott, happened here? Zum Gott. Have to close my shit. Make some scrums because with scrums I can kill the trade line.
Arma schöne
Bälle.
Zack, die zum Resources. Was gut.
Arma schöne Bälle. Arma schöne Bälle.
So, let's sell some stuff.
Get your ars. Zaars. Marvik Hrebli.
Okay, everything is giving up over here. I think I can go to the voice channel again.
Good.
Yeah.
So, hey guys, GG. I think 200 was overkill. I think even with Armenians, that could have been possible. Maybe next time, if you ever do this challenge again, I take
the Sif to getting me. Let's do it while at 150. You can only get 150 handicap.
Yeah, I think with 150 could be fair for both sides. I think that could be possible. But the thing is just, I had so many Monaspa, and Monaspa are already very strong unit on themselves, but I had so many Monaspa.
I mean, you took the strongest current Sifs with 200 handicap, GG. Absolutely stupid, to be honest.
Semper, can you translate in French with handicap, please?
Say again, I just understand handicap.
Qu'est-ce que c'est les handicaps? What is it, the handicap?
Ah, tu veux savoir ce que ça veut dire?
Yes.
Pourquoi tu parles seulement en français, pas anglais?
Anglais, j'ai du mal. I don't speak very good English.
Ah, okay.
I understand a little bit, and I learn English, but it's not.
Tu veux me donner en réponse en français ou en anglais?
En français, je préfère. Ça donne pas, ça arrive.
Le handicap, ça veut dire que tous les gens.
Okay, Champ is gone now. Champ says good night.
Yep, good night, buddy. See you around.
Good night.
Ciao, ciao.
Yep.
Yeah, he already went, guys, before you said good night.
Okay, so, Ice, the handicaps, ça veut dire, for example, si tu as 200 d'handicap, ça veut dire que les villageois, ils sont deux fois plus rapides avec leur travail. Et aussi, toutes les maisons, etc., les universités et.
Plus vite.
Je crois que la production comme normalement, mais ils ont le double de hit points. Par exemple, mes châteaux, ils ont 14 000 de hit points. Et aussi tous les bonus, comme en bonus du trébuchet contre les. Maison, c'est aussi le double. Mais les unités militaires, ils ont le même HP et ils ont aussi le même attaque. C'est premièrement un bonus économique.
Ok.
Yeah.
I see on the map, yes. The status, the unity and the castle. Je vois tout sur la map.
Okay, for you guys who don't speak French, I basically just explained to Ice what the handicap factor means and telling him that basically when you have 200 handicap, your villagers are two times as fast with the resource collection, and also all the buildings have two times the hit points, and also even attack bonuses like trebuchets versus houses and so on is also double the bonus that you would get from that.
So okay. Shall we do 3 versus 1, but this time you'll only take less the handicap?
We can try another 3 versus 1 if that's okay with you. If you want to give me another chance at winning.
Yeah, but no double cutting and stuff like that is allowed.
Yeah.
Oh, double cutting is allowed or not allowed?
Yeah, yeah, it's allowed.
It's allowed.
You want it to be allowed.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. And what handicap would you give me? I mean, 120 was by far not enough. I think like 50,
you
maybe
get
140. 140 something. 140, yeah, 140. I was thinking the same. 140, 150, something in that range. Yeah, if it's okay with you, we can do this. It means, of course, that I have to cut one more video, or I have to edit one more video for YouTube. But it's no problem.
It's okay. I'm pretty sure you can do it. You are the most amazing editor from the German newsreels.
Well, a funny thing is, I once did an internship at a TV company, and we actually went to German television. We went to the television studio in East Germany, the MDR. And we had a look at that. And also when I was studying two times in the media sector. I also had some contacts, or what does contact mean? I met some people from television. So it's funny that you bring up this topic. Let me just quickly have a look who was the best of you. Okay, Happy had a lot of kills. Champ was really good again with 70 kills. Yeah. But I mean, it's kind of unfair, of course, if you come with Imperial units and your enemies are all in Feudal Age and Castle Age still.
Yeah.
I think with 200 handicap, I probably would even win versus the Viper. So it's really an insane bonus you're getting there. Okay, we're cutting this video here. We make a cut here. Thanks, guys, for watching. As you can see, 200 handicap is completely overkill. Like, Champ alone, he's 1100 elo, he's about my level, but even he didn't have any chance. I mean, he made some camels, of course, but that was by far not enough to win this game. Yeah, so we make another 1v3. We already made 1v3 today in the early evening. And we will make another 1v3, and hopefully this time it will be a very fair and very close match that we are doing. Okay, that having been said, thanks for your attention, guys. If you want to, you can give us a thumbs up or leave a comment if there's anything going on and about on your mind. And if you want to see more videos like that, you can also subscribe to our channel. And that having been said, thanks for watching and see you next time. If you're still on, you can also say goodbye if you want to.
Oh, goodbye.
Bye.
Oh,
sure.